Hello.
There's been a murder.
And an investigation.
We did investigate.
And now there's going to be a trial.
Yeah, that's where we're headed right now. We're heading to the second class trial. I have no idea who did it.
I also have no idea who did it.
Like, we really knocked it out of the park with Teru Teru. But, like, it was pretty obvious it was Teru Teru.
As we sit here on top, I'm getting, like, mesmerized by that ocean in the background.
Oh, man. Just look at it waving.
Yeah. It can be waving. Very dangerous, though.
Oh, at night, especially.
Yeah.
Everybody knows night oceans are the most deadly of oceans. All right, well, it's weird because before it was at night.
And it was, like, ominous, and now it's...
Now it's just the daytime. Mm. Like, somebody just... Well, I guess the murder happened at night last time. Like, all of that happened at night.
Oh, it was, yep.
Yeah. How much time do you think I was going to save just out of, like, sheer habit of, like, oh, man, might mess this up, but we're just loading in from a save right now. No, gotta clean up those boobies again.
Only 800 steps, though.
I kind of just want to walk 817 steps is not a lot of steps.
What's that song? It's like, I have walked...
I would walk 500 miles.
Yeah, that one.
Yes.
That's like Hajime's theme song.
Is it?
Yeah, because we
Is
have
it
to walk
really?
To evolve our pet. And it applies.
And I would walk to grow this snake. La, da, da, la. And we can't use all this song because then we'll get sued. Although I'm pretty sure this counts as creative. What's that term? Fair use? Fair use.
His walk is like an angry march.
His arms just snap into place.
He is so determined.
I am not a robot.
Okay, let's go back.
Okay. I'm just trying to get those steps. Look, we're about to be level 28. And that's how we get the true ending.
Yeah.
Obviously.
I have no idea what the levels mean.
Neither do I. They have never come into play once.
Do they in the trial, maybe?
Do you think maybe they give us HP in the trial?
Wait, can we check our skills?
That's a great call. How do we do that?
I'm not sure. Is it in Truth Bullet somewhere?
No, I think we were supposed to buy the skills. Yeah, because there was something like you could prepare skills to like bring into the trial.
Yeah, I don't know how to prepare skills.
Okay, I think they said that it was at Rocket Punch Market.
Okay. Oh.
Well.
All right, game. I guess.
I guess we don't get skills. Probably should have bought that in free time, I guess. Look at that sweet. Look at those sweet pixels.
Yeah.
Sweet pixel portraits. Oh, wait. I wanted to see if that was enough steps. This is what this is. I'm really more concerned. See, look, our pet is nonstop pooping. I am more invested in the pet, like, development than I am. Like, we should probably give the pet ramen.
Aw.
Give your pet some soda.
But every time we get ramen for soda, we just give it to someone else.
Well... I mean, listen, by the time that we see him next, we can go get more soda.
Yeah.
For free time. And everybody knows pets love soda. Look
what
at that.
What is it doing?
Look at how much. We gave it one hope meter.
Aw.
We should fill that up a whole bunch, probably. So that maybe it'll become a good pet?
Hmm.
I don't know how that works.
Let's get to the trial.
All right, let's do it. There was a baseball bat. There was a video game.
There was an ominous letter.
There was an ominous letter. I mean, you can't just get out of this. Gonna do something crazy to you?
Who's
what?
He?
Who?
Who are you?
Oh, Monokuma?
Oh, maybe. I mean, yeah, he might.
Yeah.
Stop it!
Stop harassing little girls. That's just a little thing for everyone out there.
Aren't we all in high school? She looks like she's in, like,
She looks like
school.
Elementary school.
Yeah.
To be fair, Nekomaru looks 50.
He does.
Jeez.
He looks like a grizzled war veteran.
Yoka's still trying to run away.
Yeah, so Monokuma tried wrapping her in a full Nelson. Oh, man. Yeah.
Make me waste my sweet-ass time.
Did I ever tell you about my game that I like to play?
What's that?
It's a game I call Move the Hyphen. And every time there's...
My sweet-ass time?
My sweet-ass time. So everybody's like, yeah, I got a big-ass sandwich. And I'm like, oh, you got a big-ass sandwich?
Does it only work with the word ass?
It works with most things that are swears.
Okay, what's the problem?
Besides this one. Oh, yeah. My guess is Fuyuhiko would just straight up not show up.
He's never anywhere. He ditched my appointment.
Oh, man. Monokuma's getting rowdy. Rowdy boy Monokuma. Sweaty boy Monokuma. Whoa! Oh! What?
Hey.
He did that for no reason.
See,
it panned over to Ibuki before we really got a chance to appreciate this image.
Oh man, it's like his normal, like, belly body going straight into, like, abs? That is not right.
I'm pretty sure they just, like, saw someone make fan art of this on, like, DeviantArt, and were like, yeah, we'll take that directly, please.
Also, look at his, like, arms straight down to his little hand thing.
Yeah.
Ooh, I don't like
so
that at all.
So ripply.
I don't like that at all.
I like it so much.
Okay, let's... So no matter the ending, I have to accept it.
Yeah, I mean, we do all have to go here. If you don't, that's basically just... assuming the guilt.
Yeah.
Bastard. Accepting defeat is actually totally an option in Yakuza. You commit, like, suicide in order to preserve your honor.
Oh.
Samurai style.
I learned about that in college.
Learning things in college?
Yeah, I know, right?
That's not what college is for. College is about playing video games.
Anyway...
So all right. Is he just going to kind of, like, stick with this?
I hope so. I hope he is this for the rest of the game.
It's really scary.
It's, I mean, I wouldn't use the word scary.
Ooh.
Sexy. Definitely.
This is bad.
Yeah, dude, me neither.
Like, Soda doesn't really have to do anything.
That's true. He kind of just shows up. We're the ones who do all the work. Harness your latent energy. Bring out that energy!
This too must be the will of causality.
Beginning of the end.
I mean, this feels like maybe just exactly the middle. I don't know how long this game goes. Feels like maybe forever.
Maybe.
It feels like maybe we'll be on this island forever.
All right, Nagito.
One day we can find that shining hope. You guys are creepy.
That's right. I can only
move forward is the only option. It'd be really funny if I'm trying to move backwards, but it's not letting me. Turns out that moving forward is the only option. Should I talk to everyone?
They're all just gonna say
we should get into the let's talk to maybe she has anything about like the
sparkling
justice may hold the key. That just has to be it. What's up, Chiaki?
Because it's bad.
You remember when Chiaki was in a bikini?
Yeah, I do.
It's a good time. And, like, well, Soda could, like, barely contain himself. He was, like, a 12-year-old boy just...
I feel like Hajime could barely contain himself.
Oh, no, yeah. Hajime just experienced a boner for the first time when he saw that. All right. Listen, it's tough... going into puberty.
I do not like that.
I love that. It's just such bad taste. Most brutal taste? Is she just licking the...
Somehow I moved my muscles stiff from fear and nerves and awkwardly walked onto the elevator.
Everything Hajime does is awkward. He's never once done something in a cool demeanor.
I was eventually struck by a feeling similar to dizziness.
similar to dizziness.
But not,
not
exactly.
Not quite dizziness. Oh, what? Okay, we're just in. Are we in there?
We're just in there now.
I didn't see any animation to prove that.
A rumbling sound filled the room.
And surrounding space began to fall. We're in that elevator again. Except now there's less people.
As it shook with a clatter.
The elevator we were inside continued to drop. I continued to be an ultimate monologue student throughout the drop. I was fluctuating between the feeling of hope and despair. Oh man, I know a guy you should talk to about hope and despair.
Nagito is so excited right now.
As if my heart was rotten fruit. Ugh. Swelling in the sun before it finally goes
squish.
Squish. You know, squish. I suddenly stopped. Hey,
that's
man.
Not great.
You should probably breathe. You just see his art just crumple onto the ground.
His art just, like, he falls.
Yeah. Begin to fade from the pressure? You should probably...
After a while, okay.
Okay. Okay, he didn't pass out this time.
Whoa, why does this look different than last time?
Defeat the boring routine, that's why. It looks way different.
Decided to start redecorating.
How does it look? It looks pretty cool.
Yeah.
There's lots of, like, projection screens.
So it's gonna be different every time now, then?
Maybe.
What is your true intention?
I mean, he's definitely filming this and showing it everyone. Showing it to the world. Essentially, this killing game is just to kill time anyway? What?
Oh, until the bomb goes off? Forgetting about that giant bomb in the middle of everything.
There is a giant bomb in the middle of the island.
Yeah! To break away from my purpose. That alone is my purpose.
What? What was he made for? I'm confused. A purpose is only going to be a weakness. Those who have purpose always are always the weakest ones in the bunch. Like Nagito?
Such cheap ass purposes.
Ha! See, there you go. Another great game of Move the Hyphen. From the bottom of your heart!
You sounded like a raptor.
Ha! I apologize to everyone who.
Yeah.
I did not move away from the mic for that.
It's starting. The class trial is starting.
The second one. Oh boy. Oh, yeah,
I wasn't
cool.
expecting to see that.
Yeah, they just kind of.
She had an unyielding force of personality?
And yeah, no, okay, they used the description earlier. She had a personality. I'm not sure I would call it an unyielding force.
Yeah. Okay, she was always straightforward. Why did they show Teru Teru?
Or Mikan. Like, Mikan definitely didn't kill her.
Is Teru Teru, like, red?
Because he's... Yeah, out of the picture. Oh, yeah, look.
Huh. Ibuki is pointing like she always is.
Pointing! Maybe it's someone on this screen. Mm. Wait, who's that? Oh, that's Pekka.
There is no other way.
For us to survive.
I'm ready to find the killer. I'm ready to figure it out.
Yeah?
I have a couple guesses, and that's pretty much it.
Yep, me too. We did such a good job earlier. I'm going to continue to save in new slots in case we have audio issues again in the future. Set skills.
Oh, boy.
So.
We have 0 out of 28 skill points.
Nice.
All right. Well.
Cool. Glad that worked out. All right, we're on medium difficulty. We got these truth bullets.
Should we review them or something? Okay, I feel like these like crushed bottles are gonna come into play.
In a weird way.
In a way that the random like pose in the last one.
Oh yeah, totally. What was in the trash cans, huh? You would remember that. Pretty anime girl mask. Yeah, I'm wondering if the serial killer thing is like an attempt to throw us off the trail, or maybe there actually was a serial killer.
Mm-hmm.
shower room. Broken fish tank. Yeah, that was super weird. Why would a fish tank be in the music room?
Yeah.
I mean, unless they just have fish in their music room. Yeah, and there's all this stuff about...
like the swimsuit and everything?
Yeah, from the actual game, so which doesn't actually...
what I feel like is the swimsuit is gonna somehow come into play. I don't know how, but it's gonna have something to do, because they made such a big deal about their swimsuits earlier.
That's true.
And I'd like to think it's not just because it's like, hey, look at these sexy anime girls. Like it.
I mean,
it has to have something
more
to do.
No, I mean, it was that for sure.
But it has to also have something more to do with the case.
I think they just wanted you to look at those sexy anime girls. Who is your favorite, by the way?
Let's just move on.
But you did have a favorite.
Let's just move on.
All right, yeah, I guess let's just do this. Yeah. Class trap, start!
All right.
Now then, let's begin with a simple explanation of the class trial.
We already did this. Why Monami's just up in the rope again?
During the class trial, you will present your arguments for who the killer is and vote for who done it.
Who done it?
If you vote correctly, then only the blackened will receive punishment. But if you pick the wrong person, I'll punish everyone besides the blackened. And that person
and we'll get game over and have to retry.
Oh, no matter how many times I hear it, it's such a cruel rule.
Now then, let's first discuss the motive. That masterpiece of gaming, Twilight Syndrome.
Yeah, it was a real masterpiece.
What a masterpiece.
It was a masterpiece of something, that's for sure.
What? Cares about that game?
Oh, it's actually like the crucial thing about
this
case.
The one thing that everything
it's actually like the most important thing.
By whether or not we find Mahiru's killer.
Yeah, and that's gonna have a lot to do with the game.
Nevertheless, we shouldn't ignore it. After all, that game is the motive this time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're right. Then let's try discussing that first.
I'm sure everyone who's beaten the game already knows that it's based on an actual murder case.
Some of us have not beaten that game. Give us a detailed explanation.
It means
seems like
Twilight
something who wanted to lie about beating the game would say.
Mm-hmm.
It's a non-fiction game.
Additionally, some of us are characters in that game too.
Some of us are characters in a video game?
His reaction to that.
He's very upset that he might be in a video game.
So, I think it's better if we clarify who the characters in the game are first.
I don't want to spoil this for you guys. You're all characters in a video game. Characters in the game were Girl A, Girl B, Girl C, Girl D, Girl E, Boy F. And the high school girl who got killed at the beginning. Oh, man.
I still can't remember their last names. Why would it say Hyoko's first name, though, and everyone else's last name?
No, I think Hyoko actually is her last name.
Oh.
Oh, boy.
Mikan.
Mikan?
I believe.
Yeah. You're right.
I see.
She was the shyest.
Probably Mikan Tsumiki. That timid tone. That definitely sounds like Girl A.
Oh, if we're gonna have to do this based on the tones of the girls, I think we're a little bit in trouble.
I don't know. What are you talking? Our readings of those characters were perfect.
Actually, Girl A, we did read her.
Yeah,
kind of
no,
like
we
that.
Did.
I can't think of anyone else who would be Girl A.
This is kind of cool. The screens in the background.
Yeah.
I
actually don't think that's... I'm not sure how that works.
A nasty, trashy pig shit like you doesn't
hey,
have
Girl B.
Privacy rights.
Oh, yeah, she's Girl B.
a nasty, trashy pig shit. I feel like I heard that in the game, too.
Did I? I definitely said that with my Girl B voice, right?
I believe so.
Let me double check.
All right, let's go for it.
Let's play back the tapes.
A nasty, trashy pig shit.
Yeah, definitely. That's definitely Girl
definitely.
B. Girl B, right?
Yeah.
I see. Girl B was short and foul-mouthed.
she's
I definitely didn't pay attention to the character heights.
Actually, I could tell that Girl B was the shortest one by far.
Huh.
Which is why I thought it was funny she had that voice.
The complete opposite of me.
Anyway, let's move on.
Next is Girl C.
Oh, that's my, like...
nerdy voice.
Yeah.
But she didn't really have too many defining characteristics. We know it's not Mahiru, because Mahiru was Girl D because she took the pictures.
Oh, so who does that leave?
That leaves Ibuki.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hyper-energetic and unique.
Well, there we go.
Okay.
Okay, they're giving us enough.
Monokuma.
Monokuma! Probably. It was probably Monokuma, who I always think is unique in a way.
Girl C is Ibuki.
Girl C? Then I'll see you next Tuesday.
What does that mean?
That doesn't mean anything. She just speaks a lot. Chiaki's like,
oh my god.
The fuck are you talking about?
Let's move on to Girl B.
Let's go.
Let's move on.
Yeah, that's definitely Mahiru. It's Monokuma again. Or Fuyuhiko, I think, maybe. Is Girl D. God, I want to choose that just for, like, to hear his response
right?
of it. But I don't want to lose the hearts. Because, listen, if we have another meat bone incident.
The victim.
Right.
Yeah, that's correct. Let's skip Girl E and talk about Guy F.
Why are we skipping Girl E?
Because Girl E died in the game. Remember? Mm-hmm. He is Guy F. Sato isn't even Ibuki.
He's Abu.
Aren't you Guy F, Fuyuhiko?
Fuyuhiko's definitely Guy F.
I was in a game? That's fucking stupid.
You're fucking stupid.
He still has those little blushies.
Yeah, look at those cute little blushies.
That reminds me. Wasn't there another person whose last name was also Kuzuryu?
Yeah, the first girl to be murdered.
Another person?
Soda.
One of the another person?
There can be more than, like, 16 people? I've only ever seen 16 people in one place.
The names were Sumiki, Koizumi, Sayonji, Miyota, Sato, Kuzuryu, and then another Kuzuryu.
Yeah.
Hold on. Why do you keep saying there were two Kuzuryus?
Because there were.
Because, yeah. Listen, Nekomaru, just...
Maybe just step back and let the other
You're
people handle
You're just not
this
in
one.
This one, so maybe just chill out for a second.
It's not like I'm wrong. That's how it's written on the staff roll. Since you beat the game, you probably know what this actually means, right?
Kuzuryu, just have the hunch. His sister was the one who got murdered, yeah.
You're definitely someone I shouldn't mess with, Nagito.
Probably because he had
It's just a bug.
It's his little sister, right?
Yeah.
It's just a bug in the game.
In the game, Guy F, Kuzuryu, mentions that he has a little sister.
Ooh.
Oh, man.
What do you mean, little sister?
This is what Guy F said in the game.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's pretty clear. There's no doubt that Guy F had a little sister. Plus, the sister actually appeared in the game. That's why the name Kuzuryu appeared twice.
Yep.
It just doesn't, like, give
By the
her
way,
a...
Give the first
role
name.
Did Guy F's little sister, the other Kuzuryu, play? You probably noticed, right?
I mean, yeah. It's... Oh, boy. Yeah.
We are just gonna have to cover every inch.
The girl who died at the beginning.
I see.
The dead high school girl who was the first victim in the game is the only person I can think of.
His face is very, like, smooth, if that makes sense. It's
it
like
does
very,
not.
It's very, like, flat. Like,
based on Guy F's tone
most
in the
people
game,
have, like,
it's clear that girl
a little
e
dimension to their face. Like, you
sister.
Can see where their cheekbone would be or something.
Oh,
but, like,
yeah.
If you look, when Hajime turns his face, it's like... There are no cheekbones.
So it's the only person left.
Hajime's just a little, detective boy.
Why do you sound so fucking happy?
Oh man.
That's a winning personality you got there.
Hey man. Listen, sometimes you just gotta take a step back and look in the mirror.
Personality? Are you crazy?
Nagito does not understand sarcasm.
He'll take any praise he can get.
Even if it's just ironic.
You said the game is a work of non-fiction. That means Fuyuhiko's little sister is...
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, I have a little sister.
No, I mean, you have.
Something wrong with that?
Oh.
It's just a fucking game. Don't go mixing up some video game with reality. It's not just a game. It's definitely based on true events. That's why it's the movie. Don't go making shit up, bastard!
He's really upset about his little sister.
Yeah.
I'd have fucking killed her myself a long time ago.
Whoa.
Okay.
Well,
I mean,
not exactly the brotherly kind of tone I was expecting.
She was mouthing off to me as usual, and
sent me
it happened just the other day.
It's been a while.
About that, you're probably thinking like that because you've lost your memories.
Shut the fuck up! You be quiet!
Oh, man.
He's just an angry boy.
So you're never gonna accept that that game is based on true events,
well, that
huh?
means he's probably not the killer.
Huh.
Okay.
I mean, he definitely killed
your attitude toward this girl class trial now.
Nagito, you seem to be doubting Fuyuhiko a lot. Do you suspect he's the killer?
I mean, yeah, it mirrored the murder in Girl E.
That easy would make me feel sad. It wouldn't be good enough to serve as everyone's stepping stone. That's
oh,
why.
Man.
I'd be much happier if Fuyuhiko wasn't the killer.
Okay, you're starting out weird again.
Yep. Man, look at that tongue. Look at that tongue and those teeth. Is Soda a snake boy?
Maybe.
Just a little bit, right?
Yeah.
And that hair? I feel like he might be like a little monster boy.
Anyway. Now we've established who all the characters in the game are.
Yes, we have done that.
Girl B is Hiyoko. Girl C is Ibuki. Girl D is Mahiru. Guy F is Fuyuhiko. And the first victim in the game, that dead high school girl, is Fuyuhiko's little sister.
That's just a story in a fucking game.
A non-fiction... Listen, man, just go get... We'll get you a dictionary. You can look up what nonfiction means.
Then girl E is Miss Sato.
Could it be the same Miss Sato who likes white rice?
What?
What?
I don't know what Sato you're talking about.
Okay, I'm glad we're not the...
She's relevant to this case.
Only one. Yeah, she's
maybe
definitely
it's related
not.
To Gundam's last name, since they're both really plain names.
That's not how... That's not how names work.
Is that Wild Connection? Look at his face.
What? An ordinary family name, but it's far better than Sato or Suzuki.
Okay, weird.
Look at
weird tension.
Whoa.
Oh,
hurry up and
hello.
Talk about the mystery of the game.
Monica's like, I worked really hard on this game, you guys.
Huh? What do you mean, mystery of the game?
Down five.
My, you don't know. I heard that girl E got killed.
Early did get killed.
What? No way! Is that true?
Getting killed is so violent, don't you know?
What is this?
Such awful times we live in. Why did this happen?
It feels like they're doing like a really
like
bad...
A skit or something.
Yeah, like a bad sketch for like a company retreat.
Yeah.
Like, this is how you deal with customer service relations.
Definitely friends.
So the mystery of the game.
That was it for that.
Correct.
Then let's hurry up and solve it. Let's first figure out why Girl E was killed.
Girl E was killed because she hid the mystery. Because Girl E witnessed the murder.
Interfered?
No.
Wait, no. Girl E was the killer.
Yeah. Was Girl E the killer?
Of the first?
Yeah, Girl E was the killer. Oh, I thought Girl D got killed. Girl E was the killer.
Wait, but it's just the reason Girl E was killed.
The reason Girl E was killed is because she killed the first.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Which means Girl E was killed as revenge for the dead high school girl.
Yeah.
What do you think, Fuyuhiko? Apparently, Girl E was killed to avenge your little sister.
You're fucking persistent. I don't care what that game said at all.
But.
is that true?
Girl E. She killed the first victim?
Wait, who was Girl E again?
Girl E was Sato, the one that we don't know.
Oh.
Yeah.
The first victim's murder.
It's the murder that occurred in the music room. I knew it would come up, so I prepared in advance.
Nice going, Chiaki. Oh.
Ooh.
Oh, look at this.
Look, I made a map of the music room's surroundings, which was the stage of the first case.
Okay, so broken vase,
all this trouble?
Water tank and gravel. I don't understand that.
Mapping is second nature to retro game fans.
I mean, yeah?
Classic dungeon crawler RPGs have a first-person point of view, so mapping as you play is a base.
We get it! Let's talk about that.
Tomorrow's like, I don't care about video games! I'm a big buff boy! I don't have time to play games.
To the second floor and headed to where they heard that sound. Girl E was in front of the music room on the second floor, and she confirmed that the sound came from in there. But the door to the music room was locked. So Girl D went to get the key from the office, and when the five of them were finally able to go inside, they found the victim's body, dead from a blow to the head. The music room's window was broken. The girls thought the killer escaped through there. The sound of breaking glass that they heard at the entrance hall seemed to confirm that. Plus, Girl E's school swimsuit was stolen, so they concluded that the escape
that
killer
it wasn't
was
really
pervert.
Stolen. She just hid it.
Mm-hmm.
Pretended that
How
it was stolen.
How does that sound?
Yep, an understandable explanation. Just as expected from the ultimate gamer who excels at clearing games.
But it wasn't a pervert, right? Wasn't the real killer Girl E?
I mean, girls could be perverts.
Obviously. Girl E was waiting outside the music room for the other girls after she killed the first victim.
Did she lock the music room from the outside? Then she would have totally needed the key from the office.
Good point.
Which means Girl E was hiding that key. We can assume she used it to lock the music room after she left it.
But Girl D was the one who went to the office to get the key to the music room, right?
Man, this is elaborate.
Yeah.
By the way, since it was never mentioned in the game, we can exclude the possibility of there being a spare key.
You can lock the music room from the inside, right? So from there, Girl E broke the window and escaped, and sprinted to the front of the music room as fast as she could before the others arrived.
She would have passed by the entrance hall where the other girls were waiting if she tried to do that.
Then forget this.
It's not
just Nikamaru just gave up. It's not cute to see an old guy sulk. So it is all about cute guys.
Hey, is Girl E really...
Oh. Based on the details of the game, it's no mistake that Girl E, who is waiting in the hallway, is the killer. Then what did Girl E do after killing the girl inside the music room?
Yeah.
Guess I need to clear that up first. Girl E just said that the door was locked. It might not have been.
I thought that they...
Did they check it?
How would they have gotten... Wait, yeah, they checked it and then they had to go get the key from the office. Oh boy.
Oh boy, I don't know.
After she killed the first victim in the music room, what did Girl E do?
She just broke the window in the music room and escaped outside.
Broken vase photo?
So how did Girl E get from outside the school to the front of the music room?
To go back to the music room from outside, you need to go through the entrance hall.
Plus, at the entrance hall, the other four girls should have been there.
Hold up. We need to look at the facts. Because I do not know. Do you have any idea?
No, but we also haven't heard everyone's, like... Because so far, there have only been two things that we can shoot.
Yeah.
Okay.
Killer's escape route. Let's see. Normally, you can't leave the music room without passing through the entrance hall. entrance hall photo. One of the ending prizes, picture of Mikan, Ibuki, and Hyoko in what appears to be an entrance hall. No, so that's not it. Okay, so I think it might be the broken vase photo. She, like, tried to escape into the other room, and, like, go out one window and go into another. But I'm not sure how that works.
Yeah.
The vase was broken in the music, in the classroom next to the music room. Victim's crime scene photo. After she was killed in the music room. Girl E's crime scene photo. Definitely not anything about that. We can, like, almost eliminate the things that we know it's not.
Yeah,
right?
That's easier.
Okay, so we know it's not the girl E crime scene photo. We know it's not the entrance hall photo, because that doesn't make any sense.
So, remember, we need to find contradictions in what they're saying.
Yeah.
So once we, like, pay attention to what they're saying, if something doesn't sound right...
At the entrance hall, the girls... heard the sound of the window shattering.
Oh, wait.
Oh, that's the... That's not the window, that's the...
This is the broken vase.
Okay.
I'm waiting for the music room.
She probably used a hidden passageway. Twilight's hidden passageway is...
And then the blue ones are things that we would need to support, right?
Yep.
Girl D did after the murder in the music room. Okay, that's
after
the broken vase.
The first victim in the music room.
How do I shoot?
What did Girl E do?
She just broke the window in the music room.
Oh, why'd you go?
Oh, I didn't mean to.
Outside.
So how did Girl E get from outside the school?
I think it's just X to shoot.
To the front of the music room. To go back to the music room from outside. You need to go through the entrance hall.
That's not it.
Plus, at the entrance hall, the other four girls should have been there.
Are there four girls? There was three girls.
Hall, the girls.
Oh, wait, no, there's four, because Mahiro took
the
picture.
The window shattering.
What? Oh, I got the wrong one.
How was she able to get past us,
oh.
And it gave me a minus 10 seconds. Okay, so it's not
she
girl, it's not stolen swimsuit. Entrance hall photo, maybe? Broken vase photo, victim's crime scene photo.
It might be the entrance thing.
Yeah, maybe.
After she killed the first victim in the music room, what did Girl E do?
She just broke the window in the music room and escaped outside.
So how did Girl E get from outside the school to the front of the music room?
Yeah.
To go back to the music room from outside, you need to go through the entrance hall.
Nope.
Plus, at the entrance hall, the other four girls should have been there.
Oh, wait, that's the one.
At the entrance
nope.
hall, the girls heard the sound of the window shattering.
How was she able to...
Okay, what is it?
Okay, wait, we have to just think.
Yeah.
So she killed the victim.
Uh-huh.
Locked the door.
Locked the
so
door.
So no one could come in.
But how did she lock the door? From the inside.
Because what they're saying is she locked the door and then escaped through the window, but she couldn't have escaped through the window and gone back to the front of the door without passing by everyone.
Yeah. I don't know. It seems like it's making sense. Girl D showed Girl E this photo, and this vase is broken in the classroom next to the music room. I don't know. Do you have any idea? Any?
I don't.
No, me neither.
Well, it's not entrance hall photo, right?
Yeah.
She probably used a hidden passageway.
Okay, there's no hidden passageway.
Twilight's hidden passageway is the world's best!
What?
Wait, what did Girl E, after the murder in the music room, what did she do?
You need to find a clue that will clarify that.
What she did.
After the murder in the music room.
Wait, who took a picture?
That's Girl D.
Girl D took a picture.
Yeah.
So we have to say something about how she smashed the window, right?
Not smashed the window, smashed the vase.
But the vase is in the next room.
Yeah. Maybe there was a hidden passageway?
Maybe. We could try agreeing with it.
Yeah.
First victim in the music room.
But what would we hit it with?
What did Girlie do?
I think we would hit that with the broken vase photo.
Yeah, okay.
And escaped outside.
Okay, maybe.
So how did Girlie get from outside the school to the front of the music room? To go back to the music room from outside, you need to go through the entrance hall.
Plus, at the entrance hall, the other four girls should have been there.
Yeah, they were.
At the entrance hall, the girls heard the sound of the window shattering.
Okay, it's definitely not that.
How was she able to get past those four? Been waiting for the music room.
She probably used a hidden passageway.
Nope.
Oh wait, isn't there another button we have to hit to agree?
Oh, maybe.
Instead of...
I've been hitting the wrong button.
Oh boy.
Okay, that's not my fault.
In the music room. What did Girlie do?
Okay, so what do we say now? Now that we've realized that I've been... Okay, now let's try the broken vase photo on...
For the sound.
Yeah.
So for the window shattering sound. The school,
to the front of the music room. To go back to the music room from outside...
The game is very confusing about how... what the actual controls are.
Plus, at the entrance hall... The other four girls should have been there.
At the entrance hall, the girls heard the sound of the window shattering.
No,
yeah.
There we go. Okay, I knew that had to be it. It was just weird that that wasn't working. Now we got it.
The sound the girls
Here's
heard
the ticket.
The window breaking.
If it wasn't the window, then what broke to make that sound?
The vase.
The vase.
A vase.
A vase.
How low can you go?
What?
Drop the vase. Huh?
After the murder,
when you're waiting for the
vase
to drop.
Discovered in the classroom next to the music.
So the sound of breaking glass that the four girls heard wasn't the music.
Okay.
Window.
So that's what we talked about.
Yeah.
It just I was messing up on the controls.
So wait.
That's on me.
The sound of the vase breaking. Probably.
Actually, the murder was nearly finished by the time the four girls met in the entrance hall. Girl E killed the victim in the music room. Broke the window. And went to the office to get the key. With that key, she locked the music room from the hallway, returned the key to the office, and went back to wait in front of the music room.
Sure? And then the... How did the vase break?
Yeah, how did the vase break?
In the next door classroom, as the four girls met by the entrance.
Oh, so she still broke it.
To make them think the murder had just occurred, and that the killer had just escaped.
Oh.
So... When the four of them ran over after they heard the sound, Girl E acted like she had just rushed over too.
I see. Now the mystery has been solved.
The whole mystery.
The whole mystery. We know we solved everything.
The mystery hasn't been solved yet. You haven't determined what the murder weapon was yet.
What was the murder weapon?
Who cares
the baseball.
The murder weapon?
No, that
Wait,
was
no.
That was Girl E at the end.
Oh.
Not cool. Trouble of making this death march.
This does feel like a death march.
What the heck? You're so annoying.
Fine. Let's figure out the weapon. If this keeps up, I'm gonna feel like I need to shit.
That's his constant emotion. I didn't realize that could be emotion.
Did you see that camera move?
Yes.
You're the disgusting one.
The weapon is pretty unconventional. The answer was revealed in the game, though.
Is it the fish?
Then,
no.
Fish
she
tank?
Broke the window with the fish tank. Right?
Maybe. Well, then what's the gravel?
Inside the fish tank?
An unconventional weapon that also appeared in the game. We're told we can't advance as long as we don't make that clear. Yeah, I mean, we'll do it.
The game has no idea.
The game. Cool. Thanks,
oh,
game.
That's so funny. Terra's like crossed out thing.
Oh, is with a fork and a knife. That's weird. Now then, there's something I need to tell you regarding white noise and the non-stop debates. Some lines of white noise are actually very durable. You won't always destroy them in one shot. White noise will chip away at every time you shoot them with the silencer. But unless you completely destroy them, your time limit will not be replenished.
So all it's saying is that white noise sometimes takes a couple hits to destroy.
Yeah.
I've obtained some useful information.
I heard there's a guy named Gun something. Oh, Gundam. He has apparently a skill that can increase the power of the silencer.
Huh. Gun something.
I wonder who that could possibly be.
Why does it keep asking if it's out of line?
I don't know.
Spinning.
Broken
fish tank.
Yeah, broken fish tank, probably, right?
Probably.
A weapon inside the music room, huh?
Okay, hold on. I just wanna. So we have the broken fish tank.
Wait, let's click on it.
Gravel and water were scattered everywhere.
Okay.
Found in the music room and the body's first. Okay. So there's escape route. Victim's crime scene photo. It looks like she was just bashed in the head by something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What about broken glass?
Ooh.
No, we can't agree with that.
Isn't the cause of death a blow to the head?
Why?
I mean, just because it would be wrong. Tank.
That's too big to be a weapon.
In the piano.
Why are you going even bigger?
They could drop it down.
Universal chaos.
It's on that big a scale, too?
Nekomaru is so nervous.
Gravel instead.
What?
If it's a weapon that was used to beat them to death, it should have had blood stains.
Was there a weapon with blood stains on it? She beat her to death with her fists!
Oh, you have to get rid of the.
Yeah, pinks. The noise.
A weapon inside the music room, huh? Okay. What about broken glass?
Isn't the cause of death a blow to the head?
Yeah.
Then she attacked her with the fish tank.
Got the connection.
What is? We were agreeing with her.
Yeah. Oh man. Oh no.
A weapon inside the music.
Yeah, we were just. Oh, I guess it's broken fish tank.
What about
oh,
broken yeah. glass?
Isn't the cause of death a blow to the head?
It's definitely not the stolen swimsuit.
Her with the fish tank.
That's too big to be a weapon.
Than the piano.
Why are you going even bigger?
The
investigation conducts universal chaos.
It's on that big a scale, too?
How about beating her with gravel instead?
No, wait. I just shot it because there was an option.
Oh, come on.
Oh.
Should I do this?
Damn it.
Maybe.
A weapon inside the music room, huh?
What about
I just got
glass?
I've got no chill is my problem.
Isn't the cause well, if we wait the until head? The end to
yeah.
watch the whole thing, we don't lose
well,
points.
Well, we've seen everything.
That's too big to be a weapon.
Then the piano.
Why are you going even bigger?
Okay. The investigation conducts universal chaos.
It's on that
does
big
it
scale, too?
What?
How about beating her with gravel
no.
instead?
Nope. Oh.
If it's a weapon that was used to beat them to death.
Should have blood.
It should have had blood stains.
Should I shoot
yeah.
this? Nope. That didn't work at all.
Oh.
She beat her to death with her fists!
Ah. I'm trying to hit those things. See, yeah, that's the end of it.
An unconventional weapon that appeared
in the game. It's it's got to be the broken fish tank. I just don't know how to shoot it. It's not the stolen.
Isn't the cause of death a blow to the head? Then she attacked her with the fish tank.
That's too big to be a weapon.
Wait, what are other options?
Crime scene photo.
Why are you going even bigger?
Broken fish tank. Killer's escape route.
Universal chaos.
It's on that big
what
a
else?
Scale too.
What did have blood on it? There was the water though, so. What was on the blow to the head? Was she even killed in that room? I don't know. What do you think?
Um,
Anything?
I'm thinking, maybe we should use the vase, the photo of the vase again? No, that was the last thing.
Yeah, that was the last thing.
Maybe we should use the broken fish tank when, she says that it would have had blood stains. Then we could say, like, the fish
water
tank, water from the fish tank
washed it away.
Yeah.
Gravel and water were scattered everywhere.
You
okay,
at least try.
Yeah. That's what I was trying to do to shoot him. Let me double check the rules. Okay. Fire truth bullet.
Is why.
Yeah, is why. That's what I attempted to do. Silencer is X. That's what I... Oh, and we can fast forward the argument to the point that we want to shoot.
How about beating her with gravel instead?
If it's a weapon that was used to beat them to death, it should have had blood stains.
Nope, see?
Weird.
Surprising amount of blood shoots out.
Oh
boy. Okay, so it's not that. Oh boy, we're losing some health on this.
Inside the music room, huh? What about broken glass?
Isn't the cause
okay, I don't know what it is.
Think you talked her with the fish tank.
That's too big to be a weapon.
Then the piano.
Could it be the broken vase photo again?
Why are you going
maybe
bigger?
But the vase would have already been broken at that point. And they would have heard the glass shatter.
How about beating her with gravel instead?
If it's a weapon that was used to beat them to death, it should have had blood stains.
What if it was the killer's escape route?
The window?
Yeah. She like bashed her head into the window?
Oh, maybe. Okay, let's try that. Let's
okay,
try killer's escape route.
Okay, but on what?
Weapon inside the music room, huh?
What about broken glass?
Maybe that one?
No.
Isn't the cause of death a blow to the head?
Because that's one that we would agree with.
Think you attacked her with the fish tank.
Yeah, okay, no, not that.
That's too big to be a weapon.
Then the piano.
Why are you going even bigger?
An investigation conducts universal chaos.
It's on that big a scale, too?
How about beating her with gravel instead?
No.
If it's a weapon that was used to beat them to death, it should have had blood stains.
That's it, though. That's all.
No. Okay, yeah, it's not that. Okay, I think it's the photo.
The vase photo?
Yeah, the vase photo.
That's what I was saying before.
Oh, no. Not the vase photo. Victim's crime scene photo. Because there's not that much blood there.
That's true.
So we can counteract what he's saying.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay,
isn't the
so let's just fast forward to
it.
That's too big to be
in the piano.
Why are you going to
the investigation?
It's on that biggest.
How about beating her with gravel?
If it's a weapon that was used to beat them to death, it should have had blood stains.
Okay, I don't know what it is.
Damn it.
We're running out of time and stuff. I don't know what to do. What do you think? What do you need to know the controls?
Broken fish tank, killer's escape route. Okay, there was a broken window in the music room where the first victim's body was discovered. Normally you can't, okay.
Okay, what is it though? Like, this doesn't even seem relevant to the case at all.
I know.
Is the frustrating part. Victim's crime scene photo. Okay, so what? What are even the options again?
Victim's crime scene photo.
Broken vase photo.
Stolen school swimsuit.
Okay, wait. Yeah. Maybe it wasn't a blow to the head.
Maybe it was like strangling.
Yeah, but why would she have blood?
Yeah, no, that doesn't make sense.
But no. But maybe just from the struggle of, like, hitting something. But still, yeah, it might have been...
But no, wait, click on it. Yeah, she just, who appeared, had her swimsuit stolen by someone. I don't know. I think it might be the swimsuit.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, well, where?
Where they say a blunt object. We don't know that she was killed by a blunt object. Go look at her crime scene photo. It just says she was killed.
Yeah.
Like, we see a hit to the head.
Yeah.
But we don't know if that's actually the cause of death.
That's true.
Yeah. And Fuyuhiko's right. If we were to, like, you know, bash someone's head in, there'd be way more blood.
So, okay, so if it's swimsuit, where would... I thought the whole point of the swimsuit was just that she hid the swimsuit to make it seem like some perverted...
She would also hide the murder weapon.
That's true.
Yeah.
So where should we do that one?
I think it's where they say they bashed in the head.
Uh-huh.
Like, if it was, like, a blunt object, it uh-huh. wasn't that.
Okay.
Yeah. Here, should I...
What about broken glass?
We want to get more time by clicking on those things.
Yeah, I mean, listen, we are also run. Her with the fish tank. Oh wait.
That's too big to be a weapon.
Then the okay. piano. We're gonna run out of time.
Why are you going even bigger?
Yeah.
Like, that's just all this will happen. Investigation conducts universal. I don't know what'll happen. Like, we just don't have a chance. Oh, I didn't even intend to do that.
It should have had blood stains.
No, I don't know what to do. I'm not saying we beat her with that. A weapon inside the music room, huh? We've tried just about everything. Okay, let's just run out of time. What happens? Do we just get a game over? Okay. It's just gonna think that he did it for no apparent reason? What?
What is going on?
I think we get a game over because the time ran out. And then, yeah, we just get the...
Okay.
Okay, just everyone dies. Yes, and then we have to retry. We will never give up. Okay, that's a bummer that we had to do a retry. But, like, this makes no sense. Just, it's... Whatever the argument is supposed to be...
Okay, wait, let's just... Can we review these now?
Yeah.
Broken fish tank, killer's escape route... Oh.
Okay, broken fish tank, killer's escape route, stolen school swimsuit, broken vase photo.
Isn't the cause of death a blow to the head? Then she attacked her with the fish tank.
Broken fish tank, killer's
That's
escape route,
to be a weapon.
Stolen school then swimsuit, broken vase photo. Why none of it makes sense.
Okay, I think that we should do the fish tank with the broken glass chaos. Like Soda said.
Okay.
That big a scale too?
How about beating her with gravel instead?
What?
So
yep.
Just get the extra if time if you can.
Let's see, if I miss fire, then it minuses 10 seconds. Stains.
Was there a weapon with blood stains on it?
I need she something to counteract the blood stains. Apparently that it appeared in the game, but...
Something that appeared in the game is the... Music, the broken fish tank is all I can think
of. What about broken glass?
That. Okay.
No, he's just angry at us.
Damn it!
Yep, nope, not that.
A weapon inside the music room, huh?
What is it?
What about broken glass?
Isn't the cause of death a blow to the head? Then she attacked her with the fish tank.
So it's not the fish tank.
That's too big to be a weapon.
Then the piano.
Okay, victim crime scene. This just feels like we're putting together a really bad puzzle.
Yeah.
Like, this doesn't feel...
It's on that big a scale, too?
Like, this whole conversation doesn't feel relevant to anything else.
If it's a weapon that was used to beat them...
I want to try victim's crime scene photo one more time.
That did, yeah.
No. Okay, that's not what I'm trying to... That's not the argument that I'm trying to make, which is the frustrating part.
What about broken glass?
Isn't the cause of death a blow to the head?
Broken base photo.
Think you attacked her with the fish tank.
That's too big to be a weapon.
Should I try broken fish tank? Did we get broken fish tank with attacking with the fish tank?
Why are you going even bigger?
Did we support that yet?
I think we did, and then Nekomaru just says that it's too big.
Let's try one more time.
Okay.
Because, like, we've got nothing else to lose. It's not beating with gravel. Might as well try it. The only thing we get is...
Damn it! We already tried that one before.
A weapon inside the music room, huh? What about broken glass?
Isn't the cause of death a blow to the head?
Then she attacked her with the fish tank.
That's... What is the connection between saying that we're... Saying... What with what we're saying about there being a broken fish tank?
Is there a button to agree with someone, or is that not...
Damn it!
I think it's the same button. Yeah, it's just the same button.
What does concentrate mean?
Concentrate just slows down time, but you run out of that star power.
Oh.
What about broken glass?
Killer's escape route and broken glass, maybe? Because the killer's escape route was the window?
No, that doesn't make any sense, though.
That's too big to be a weapon.
Then the piano.
Why are you going even bigger?
The investigation
conducts... To be fair, none of this makes any sense. This is just genuinely frustrating.
If it's a weapon that was used to beat them, it should have had bloodstains.
I agree with that.
Was there a weapon with bloodstains on it?
No.
She beat her to death with her fists!
Maybe that's the thing we're supposed to disagree with? That last thing?
How would she beat her to... What would we agree with?
Maybe we should use the broken vase photo?
She... No, remember, she strangled her. Remember?
Oh, so we should use the swimsuit with the, for the last one.
Yeah.
Okay, let's try it. Let's just try it.
Let's totally try it. She strangled her with the swimsuit.
What about broken glass?
Can you fast forward?
Yes. It still speeds up the time, too.
Why are you going even bit the investigation? It's on that big a scale.
But yeah, no, she strangled her. I can't believe we forgot that detail.
But, well, we thought that... Remember, we were trying to say that, but we were trying to counteract this.
We were trying to do it
point.
Here, instead of we weren't paying attention all the way to the end.
She beat her to death with her fists!
Oh. Wait.
Damn it!
What the hell?
A weapon inside the music room, huh? What about broken glass?
Okay. What? Okay, we know she strangled her, because she admitted that at the end of the game. But how do we... Like, straight up, she says she just choked her. I actually think she drowned her.
Oh, but yeah. Wouldn't she be wet?
Oh, maybe. What is...
Can I see?
Yeah. None of the clues actually, like, give any, like, heads up about what it could be.
Okay, there's broken window in the music room. Broken fish tank. It has to do with the water, probably.
I don't know. It's either broken window or broken
fish tank.
Okay,
because, like, Sonya said, she killed her with the fish tank. Nekomaru said, that can't happen, it's too big. So it's not broken fish tank, right?
Yeah.
It's not the escape... I don't think it's the escape route.
Okay. Why don't we have a clue that just says she told us how she did it?
Yeah. Do you want to try using broken vase photo? We haven't tried that yet.
I mean, use it wherever you think you want to use it.
Okay, how do I...
Hit Y or a triangle over whatever you want to agree with.
Wait, how do I get to with the fish tank?
That's too big to be. You have to clear out the noise in front of it.
Oh, with X?
Yeah, with X.
Why are you going even bigger?
The investigation conducts universal chaos.
It's on that big a scale too?
Okay, we know the answer.
How about beating her with gravel instead?
No.
If it's a weapon that was used to beat them to death, it should have had blood stains.
I don't think that's... I don't think it's the broken base photo. That doesn't make any sense.
She beat her to death with her fist!
Yeah, miss. See, you know, you have to clear out the noise. Here, let's pause for a second. Can you pause? Hit start. All right. So we had to pause for a second because this is getting frustrating.
So we just had to look up just literally this one answer.
This one answer, that's all we saw, because we just didn't want to be sitting here all day trying to, like, every single possibility.
And the actual answer does not make sense, but let's just show you
what the actual answer is, because it's just as confusing.
What about broken glass?
So it's...
Isn't the cause of death a blow to
it's
the head?
Stolen school it's swimsuit.
On.
You attacked her with the fish tank.
Not that.
That's too big to be a weapon.
Stolen school swimsuit. In the piano.
Why are you going even bigger?
Let's hope we don't run out of time for it.
Investigation conducts universal K.
It's on that big a scale.
How about beating her with gravel and...
It's this.
It's beating her with gravel for stolen
instead,
school swimsuit.
That makes no sense. You're agreeing with that with stolen school swimsuit?
Must have used gravel to attack the victim.
But
what?
Oh wait, I get it now.
How?
You put the gravel inside the swimsuit and use it as a blunt object.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Okay, no, that's super dumb. There was no clue insinuating that could possibly
okay,
be
there
it.
There were no hints, but I just got it just when he said that.
My that's goodness. I got it right.
No, that's
and I was just throwing things out there.
Yeah, you were.
Yeah, you were. Cause we had way better things to like say than what.
Let's just move forward.
I'm very frustrated about this.
I'm chosen by the gods.
I wouldn't go that far.
You're not chosen at all. And gravel is impossible. It's too small to be a weapon.
What if the gravel was put inside some sort of bag?
There is no straight up insinuation or hint or clue that this would be the weapon.
The weapon is something that appeared in the game, and so is the bag. And the only thing I can think of is the school swimsuit.
Are you serious?
If you tie the swimsuit like a bag and stuff it full of gravel, it'd make an effective weapon.
Gravel inside the swimsuit? Even the ace attorney would be astonished by such a fantastic idea!
Yeah.
They seriously just said, Phoenix Wright ace attorney.
For the killer, it's an idea that kills two birds with one stone.
Is it?
People think the killer is some pervert. It makes sense for a school swimsuit to be stolen.
Yeah.
I get that.
If that swimsuit was used to make an improvised weapon, it'd have to be disposed of later.
But like strangling or anything else makes way more sense.
Yeah.
How about it, Monokuma? Are you satisfied now?
This happiness you feel when the mystery you create is solved.
That was a terrible mystery.
Know this feeling of ecstasy.
Very few games make me feel like legitimate anger and like frustration towards them to this extent.
Girlie had someone who can be called an accomplice. That person was actually Girl D.
Girl D.
You're talking about Mahiru, right?
Huh? Mahiru is the accomplice?
She took the photos.
What does that mean?
The piece of face that became an important clue in the music room murder. Girl D got rid of it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Made sure to throw it away.
And that's why they met up.
Apparently the reason Girl E committed murder in the first place was to protect Girl D.
So Girl E was super protective of Girl E, or Girl D.
Girl E found out and tried to stop it. And they ended up getting into an argument.
And she felt a rush of anger and ended up killing her.
Okay, in a rush of anger, You cannot grab a swimsuit, fill it with gravel, and beat someone to death with it. That is not something that you do in a rush of anger.
Okay, so say these two girls are, like, standing in the room, right? She'd be like, hey, why are you reaching into that fish tank and taking a... Why are you putting it in... What are you doing?
We're just having an argument right now. What? Okay, so she choked her out because she confessed to that earlier in the game.
Mm-hmm.
She probably made her unconscious by accident.
You don't make someone unconscious by accident, okay? That's a very pleasant way of thinking about it.
I somewhat understand that feeling.
What?
That's pretty scary.
It is pretty scary.
Killed by someone on the fourth day, or the game's last day. I might as well ask just in case.
I mean, we know it was the guy.
Yeah. Guy if.
It's probably Girl D.
Monokuma.
Girl D probably killed Girl E.
Should have been Guy F.
He's sweaty now.
Man, I'm sweaty now. Yeah, I will never forgive her.
That's really creepy.
Guy F murders Girl E out of a burning hellfire desire to avenge his murder.
I mean, I kind of get that.
but Guy F is...
I mean, Fuyuhiko straight up said that he has murdered people before.
That's all you can say. If that game is telling the truth, it'd be a huge problem for you.
Hey, clear this up.
He's a Yakuza boss. They kill people all the time.
In the game, do you remember this incident?
No, because we all got our memories erased.
Yeah, we got our memories erased.
Remember? That's obvious. Because their school memories were like...
I didn't realize Monokuma was a valley girl.
Even if I don't remember, I already know. It's obvious that guy is the killer.
But he must not be because it's too obvious, right?
And he didn't know anything about this game.
That's true, he never played it.
Yeah.
Girl E and Mahiru were killed by that guy.
I bet that someone thought that it would be Fuyuhiko. So they tried to frame him.
Yeah, using like the baseball bat thing.
Mm-hmm.
Because it was the same murder weapon as in the late game.
Well, I'm used to it by now.
But does Mahiru's murder have anything to do with that game? Perhaps the two are unrelated.
No.
Yeah, it was the motive. They both had the baseball bat. Oh, I didn't. Oh, I just have to choose.
Metal bat.
I can prove it with this. I'm not sure the two events are unrelated. At the very least, the killer has definitely played the game. As proof, Mahiru, who was killed in the beach house, and Girl E, who was killed in the game, were both killed by a blow to the head with a metal bat. There's no way we can ignore that connection.
Cannot ignore that connection.
Someone must have wanted to split her head open the exact same way they avenged the first victim. Hey, why don't you confess already? You are the one who killed Mahiru, right?
Us? Oh, okay, he was done. I was like, what?
There's no way a stupid game
us,
could be
the people playing
the
this game.
The players of the video game?
We killed her just by playing this game.
If you think about it, if we never played this game...
She never would have died.
None of these people would have died. This is all our fault.
Stupid game, and that's why you killed her as revenge.
If you keep he doesn't believe the game.
That, we're just going to go around in circles. And it's true Fuyuhiko may look suspicious. Don't you think that'd be too obvious?
Mm-hmm.
What I mean, it was just like how Nagito looked way too obvious to be the killer.
Yeah.
I mean, there's a possibility that it's a trap set by the true killer.
Exactly.
Trap? What do you
and
mean?
Maybe it's, maybe it's Sonya because she hasn't spoken this whole time.
That's
and also
very true.
She knows about the whole, like, Sparkling Justice thing?
Yeah, the serial killer Sparkling Justice, but I don't know what Sparkling Justice has to do with this yet.
That person could be using that knowledge to try to set up Fuyuhiko.
Are you saying that a completely different killer murdered Mahiru and used the game motive as their cover?
Yes.
Yes.
Isn't that what happened?
Ooh.
Whoa.
Don't you understand? I'm saying you might be the true killer.
Do you have any evidence for that? Whoa! I should did have that toilet accident in the first game. Okay, footprints on the beach. Yeah, footprints on the beach.
You four-eyed troll? Accusing me of killing Mahiru?
Well, they were her footprints, so she was there. Yeah. If she tries to say she wasn't.
Yeah.
Do you know where Hyoko was today? She was at the beach house, the scene of the crime.
Oh,
we have to agree.
But I didn't go to the beach house.
Oh, wait, no. That.
No, that's wrong.
Yeah. See? Sometimes.
That's where I'm supposed to go.
This part makes sense.
You should have been at the beach house, Hyoko.
Seriously, I told you I didn't.
We all saw you run.
But these footprints in the sand in front of
we
the
did
beach
see her run away from the beach crying.
I don't have such ugly footprints. They're probably Mikan's based on how ugly they are.
Don't decide that based on ugliness.
Huh. They're not Yoko's footprints? That's strange.
Look at Nagito do his work.
Do you think maybe Nagito fudged the footprints?
Oh, I hope not.
Yeah, right? It feels like he's actually trying to help now in a weird way.
And also, that gummy
was in the
closet.
Supposed to be the same age. The gummy was in the closet. But I don't think it was her. Her and Mahiru had a really good relationship.
Yeah.
Which means when the owner of these footprints went inside the beach house, they used a different entrance.
The window?
A different entrance.
No. For a different entrance, they would have to gone in the way the door that Mahiru was up against.
Yeah.
So they were already in there by the time. So you had mentioned that maybe Hyoko went into the closet to hide. If a killer came in and Mahiru tried to stop them and Hyoko hid and then
ran after the killer was gone.
Yeah.
And the killer probably escaped through the window, which is why the killer's footprints
aren't there
on the sand. But then how would the killer reach the window?
The door was still accessible when they went in and wasn't when they left. Which means something happened between those two events.
Something happens between every two events.
Unless Hyoko was planning murder with the killer.
I doubt it.
Oh, I remember now. I remember when I went to the beach house.
How convenient.
So you finally decided to confess.
I'm pretty sure you guys already know this, but going for walks in the morning is my daily routine.
I did not know that.
Daily routine before.
Yeah.
And that's when I went to the beach house. I went there on my morning walk.
No.
I see. If you went there,
we've got that note.
Walk,
yeah.
Have anything to do with the case at all?
Akana is just ready to believe.
Don't believe her so easily, dumbass. She's obviously lying.
Huh? It's a lie.
Akana.
You call other people liars are usually liars themselves. If you say I'm lying, prove it. Can you even prove that I'm lying? There's no way a bunch of
worthless
idiots like you guys would be able to do that.
Okay.
So either the gummy or
letter on Mahiru.
I did go to the beach house, but only during my morning walk.
No.
I didn't go any other time.
Then you didn't meet up with Mahiru at the beach house?
Obviously not.
Oh, come on.
Saying I met up with her when I never even saw her?
Oh wait, I don't
think that's it. Idiots.
Okay, so that's all.
Okay. Maybe it is the first one.
I did go to the beach house.
When she says only time.
But only during my morning walk.
There we go.
No, that's wrong.
There we go. I think we're gonna get these slashies. Maybe the.
Only during your morning walk, huh? Will you still claim that after you take a look at this letter?
Oh snap! Couldn't find you, so I put this in your. Oh yeah.
About what we discussed earlier, is it okay if we change the place and time? I want you to come to the beach house on the second island at 2:30.
I didn't even remember that there is a specific time on it.
Yeah, it seems there's someone who wants to interfere with our meeting.
Who would want to interfere with
our
meeting?
Let's keep it a secret. Until then, let's try not to see each other for a while.
Bad if they started suspecting us for no reason. Hyoko.
That letter! It's the one Mushroom had, right?
I see.
Unless the killer planted it there. To arrange a meeting
with Mahiru by exchanging letters with her. That seems unlikely.
What is that letter?
Oh, maybe.
I'm serious. I don't know.
Oh, snap. I remember now. I totally saw you.
Huh?
Me and Hajime met up at the diner around 3 p.m. to go to the beach. I saw you about 30 minutes later, so it should have been around 3:30 p.m.
See. So if she met Mahiru at 2:30 p.m., killed her, then ran away afterward.
Okay.
I think 3:30 p.m. is a reasonable time for you to have witnessed here.
You're wrong! You're totally wrong!
Just tell us what you know.
Yeah.
Also passed by the diner Fuyuhiko, so you should have seen Hyoko too, right?
No, I didn't. It's just a coincidence that I passed by the diner. I wasn't even paying attention to the beach house. I went straight back to my cottage after I saw you guys. I didn't see anyone during that time.
For some
little
reason,
grumpy guess.
That sounds suspicious too.
That sounds suspicious.
Deal with it.
Just leave it.
Deal with it.
It'd be a waste of time to question him any further. Anyway, that letter in Kazuichi's testimony says it all. You were meeting up with Mahiru at the beach house.
Yeah.
Seriously? I don't know. I didn't even write that letter.
Unless she's not lying about this part.
The truth.
Yeah.
I really, really don't know.
She seems to be telling the truth. Otherwise, she would just be getting angrier rather than sad.
Lying? Or is she faking it?
Is that just sand behind her? Is that just a pile of sand?
Faking it.
Nekomaru just probably faking it. I don't know. It's girl stuff crying. I've never done it once.
With the intention of killing her all alone. That's why she wrote a letter to let her know where to meet.
Unless it was you who wrote it, Peko.
Ooh, maybe.
Hid yourself in a specific place and waited. There's evidence for that, too.
Unless you planted the gummy!
Oh, snap, I think Peko planted the gummy. Because it's not the same brand and flavor.
Yeah! She doesn't know her brand and flavor. She just sees her eating gummies and... Oh.
Spot selection. Oh, we just have to choose... Okay, well, we know it's here.
Yeah.
Here! The place where Hyoko was hiding. Are you talking about the closet?
Yes. That's right.
See? She's trying to...
Yeah, she's planting
candy.
A bunch of evidence.
Yeah.
Your favorite candy is gummy.
Oh, snap. Peko, why could you do this to me? And she was swimming.
Yep, because... Maybe washing the blood off of her?
Yeah, probably.
Maybe she was in that shower room.
Oh, well, no, but the shower doesn't work.
Oh.
Lay it on me, Gundam.
Like, maybe she took water from those bottles to wash herself off in the shower, and that's why the bottles are in the trash.
Maybe.
Maybe.
That's a... Yeah, maybe.
What would the bottles have anything to do
with
that? It's
a very good question.
Hyoko, who summoned Mahiru to the beach house, hid inside the closet like a familiar.
Okay.
When she saw her chance, she attacked her like an evil spirit and left the beach house like a swift wind.
I could just... I want Gundam to start doing, like, books on tape. You know, just get on Audible.
Mahiru's body would be blocking the door at that time. Because
no,
that,
Peko.
She was only able to leave from the beach side door and ended up leaving her...
She wouldn't be so involved in trying to lead us off the case.
If it wasn't her.
My four dark devas of destruction didn't even need to come out.
But I kind of wish they would because they're
really
so cute.
It's a trap. This is obviously someone's
trap. Yeah, man, a whole bunch of people trying to lead them off the trail of all this stuff.
It must be that one person. You know, the one with the mask, maybe?
Sparkling justice.
The one with the mask.
But Sonya still hasn't spoken this
Sonya
whole
has
time.
Not spoken at all.
You're the one who wore that mask and killed Mahiru, right?
Okay, well, we have lots of proof against...
Childish mask. Is your brain fried or something?
That is right. It cannot be Hyoko. That mask belongs to Sparkling Justice.
It does.
Huh? Unless Peko is Sparkling Justice and that's why she has that weapon, because she's the ultimate swords woman.
Yes, yeah.
That mask says it all. Spark. sparkling justice is hiding on this island.
Oh no, remember, Sonya thinks that no one did it. She thinks that the serial killer has been here since the beginning. Like hiding.
Huh.
Why you? If you continue to say such foolish things, I shall tear you again.
Everyone on this island is like a little bit too fighty.
Yeah.
Don't blame Miss Sonya. It's just a difference between cultures. Culture shock, you know?
That's what that is, right?
You just admit it already. You're being unreasonably stubborn.
She is. There is something strange. Something doesn't make sense. I can't help but feel like we're being directed by someone.
Yeah, someone's
Echo!
Ultimate director!
Make your argument!
Footprints, trash can.
Yellow gummy bag.
Gummy bag.
I shall render my bird. It's either yellow gummy or gummy bag.
Hiyoko is the sinner who killed Nahiru.
I like one of the options.
Maybe that could be it, but let's wait.
No.
You went to the beach house, right?
I mean, she did. We've established that.
And weren't you also hiding in the closet?
And then they're going to mention
so
the gummy.
That's when you dropped the gummy. You waited for your chance to kill Mahiru. And afterward, you fled from the beach house.
I think the thing that we should hit is drop the gummy by Fuyuhiko.
Maybe.
So you were forced to flee from the beachside entrance.
And that's how you left your footprints.
Okay.
Yeah, I think it's Fuyuhiko saying that's when you drop the gummy.
Okay. Let's footprints on the beach, conclusion. Trash can, yellow gummy, killer's escape route.
Gummy bag.
You think it's gummy bag?
I do. I really do.
You went to the beach house, right?
And weren't you also hiding in the closet? So that's when you dropped the gummy. No, that's wrong.
Oh, you're totally on it.
About that gummy, did Hyoko really?
There we go. Yeah, that's the same idea I wanted to get across. But yeah, I would not have thought to.
Is that midget over there?
You're a midget too, you know. You're the one who worries about never getting taller.
Does he worry about that?
It's true, Hyoko likes to eat gummies.
That's cute if he does.
But he only eats a specific brand.
Yeah.
The brand of gummies you eat only have strawberry, melon, grape, and orange flavors, right?
Huh? But what about the lemon flavor? The gummy at the crime scene is yellow. So it obviously looks like it's a lemon flavor.
Huh? That gummy is yellow? And it's not mine! The ones I eat don't have any yellow gummies.
It's true.
Gummies is such a funny word. Yeah,
Pecco.
See? Pecco.
Pecco, how could you do this?
That's right. None of the gummy bags in her cottage had any yellow ones.
Then we can't assume Hiyoko is the one who dropped that yellow gummy.
See? Didn't I tell you? It's definitely a trap.
It is a trap.
Damn it.
Someone who would try and frame two different people?
Two different people, yeah.
Yeah, well, just choose one.
Well, that kind of makes you seem like the killer.
No, I mean, that's just kind of cute.
Hold on, you little bitch.
Whoa.
You think you're in the clear just because of a little gummy? Don't be stupid. I'm not done backing you into a corner yet.
Dude.
If you're wrong, everyone dies. So just calm down.
Okay, here we go again. Gummy bag. Mikan's autopsy report.
That's new.
Yeah. All right, let's hear what it all is yet.
There's still a huge piece of evidence left.
Is there?
You're talking about the footprints near the beach house, right?
It's true. That's an important piece of evidence. And we can thank Mahiru for it.
Mahiru left?
What does that mean? Mahiru used her last ounce of strength and blocked the door to the road. Thanks to her. We have the evidence we need.
Oh, no.
That's wrong.
She didn't.
The body
was dragged.
The body was dragged, yep.
During my morning walk.
But I don't think that's Mikan's autopsy report.
Okay, let's figure it out. Let's double check the stuff. Let's see if it is the...
Yeah, it might be in there.
Mikan's autopsy report. Blow from the head and died instantly. Blow from the head behind the head. From behind. She couldn't have blocked the door with her. So it is the Mikan's autopsy report. Yeah, it's from behind.
So now we need to figure out where to shoot it.
Yeah. I think it's the one where she's saying, blocked the door. And died instantly. And we can thank Mahiru for it. Because, yeah, she was dragged.
Mahiru used her last ounce of strength and
blocked the door to the road. I'm trying to counter that, but I need to.
We have the evidence we need.
That's wrong.
That is wrong.
I left those footprints during my morning walk.
That's also wrong. Okay, I gotta.
We're not done with Hyoko yet. There's still a huge piece of.
You're talking about the footprints.
It's true. That's an important. And we can thank Mahiru for it.
What does that mean?
Mahiru used her last ounce of strength and.
There we go.
No, that's wrong.
Man, that noise was right over it.
Yeah.
Mahiru didn't block the door. Her death was instant.
Instant death?
Looks terrified
because
by
Pekko
that.
Knows how to do that.
Yeah, with a single hit.
If you keep making shit up, I'll fucking kill you!
Dude, hey man, if you want to have a bigger part of these trials, maybe come to the investigation.
Yeah.
Don't just lock yourself up into a room like a baby.
I'm sorry. Ryuhiko, you cannot do that. Only a coward threatens women.
I'm pretty sure her death was instant, too. I mean, her injury was only a single blow. That's why Mahiru isn't the one who blocked the door. Someone else used her body to block it.
And set it up and made it look like the murder weapon to frame other people.
Someone else?
The killer, of course. They're the one who blocked the door with Mahiru's body. That's why there were bloody drag marks left on the floor.
But why did the killer block the door?
To get to the other side?
Just ask
Kyoko. That's had the exact same tone of why did the chicken cross the road.
Seriously, that's not true.
Let's assume Kyoko is the killer. Wouldn't that mean she's also the one who dragged the body?
Seems difficult for Kyoko to.
Yeah.
Her clothes and skin would have been stained with blood.
And that's why you needed to wash it off.
With
the water bottles.
With the water.
And that's why she was all wet.
Yeah, and she wasn't covered in blood.
See? I told you I wasn't the killer! Yay! With this, my innocence has been proven!
I won't let you look down on me!
Oh boy. We're gonna get one of these side-by-sides.
We haven't decided that yet.
Hey, Fuyuhiko. Why do you keep insisting that Hyoko is the killer?
Shut up! I'm telling you, she's the killer! That little bitch is definitely the killer!
He's so insistent on that.
Yeah. Rebuttal, showdown. Okay, I mean, we gotta figure out what's.
Mahiru didn't block the door. Then Hyoko did it. She killed Mahiru and blocked the door with her body. Hyoko is the only killer I can think of.
If Hyoko moved the body, then she should be covered in blood.
So what, dumbass? There's a shower room inside the beach house.
Oh, wait.
After she moved the body.
Oh, but it's broken.
Yeah. Washed it off in the shower.
There we go.
Through those words.
Did it. First try.
Nice.
I'm excited about that. It feels good when you get it on the first try.
Impossible, because the shower in the beach house was out of order.
There we go.
Out of order?
If you ever left your room, you nerd.
I'm terribly sorry. I haven't had any time to actually repair it.
Then maybe she took her clothes off to move the body, and when she was done, she put them.
Not allowed
on.
To change clothes in the building.
Oh yeah.
Are you saying I did something that perverted?
Oh yeah.
She can't
also
get dressed
can't
by herself.
Get... Yeah.
I see.
Listen to me, Fuyuhiko. Kyoko mentioned this before.
Yeah, she can't tie her kimono sash, which is why her and Mahiru
Which means
we're meeting up
to go to the shower. It's impossible for her to they've had showers before.
What?
Oh yeah. She couldn't even tie her sash on her own. That's why she couldn't take a bath and smelled bad.
I didn't smell. It only smelled a little.
Oh, wasn't changing inside the beach in the first place?
Yes, if you broke the rules, I'm pretty sure Monokuma wouldn't have kept quiet.
No, he would have killed you on sight, because that's what he loves to do more than anything.
Literally, the second that we, like, heard that changing in the beach house wasn't allowed, I'm pretty sure we both said, this is gonna come this up,
is,
isn't it?
Yep, this is a clue for
whenever
something.
Whenever they have rules, it's always like...
Yep.
Damn right! I'm such a stickler for the rules!
Because he's such a stickler! Classic stickler. What?
If she didn't change her clothes, then what did Hyoko do with the blood that got on her?
Like I've been saying, the blood wasn't on me in the first place, because I never touched Mahiru's body.
Yeah, she didn't do it.
If you think about it the other way around, does that mean whoever was covered in blood is suspicious?
Yeah, dog. Anyone covered in blood should be suspicious.
Akane was covered in blood.
Oh, no.
But I don't think it's her.
Because she's also got hit in the head. That one makes it.
Yeah.
I believe Akane was soaked with blood when we all met up to go to the beach.
Didn't I tell you that was because I got beat up by Coach Nekomaru?
Can Nekomaru confirm? Okay.
Yep.
If I hadn't gotten that rough with her, she never would have backed out.
Doubt me of all people. You got some nerve.
Kana's just always ready to fight and eat.
Your body in half so you're stuck in a bowing position for the rest of your life. That actually sounds pretty cool.
Does it?
The hell it does.
Hey,
thank you, Soda.
More importantly, I'm okay now, right?
You are.
It's okay that I'm not the killer?
It is okay that you're not the killer. Thank you for not killing.
See? I already told you. There's no way I'd kill Mahiru.
Yeah, they were like the best friends.
Mahiru taught me how to wear a kimono, and she was very, very kind. There's no way I would kill a nice person like her. Why wouldn't you believe me earlier?
Because somebody tried to frame you.
You guys are stupid! Stupid, stupid, stupid! Hyoko... Please don't cry. Everything is fine now, right?
Shut the hell up, pig bark!
God, what a turn!
I'm sorry for being pig bark.
Mikan, jeez.
It was definitely strange.
Behavior was strange for sure. So was Pekko, though.
Yeah.
Hey, Hyoko. Now that our suspicions have been addressed, can you tell us the truth?
Huh?
Even though you're not the killer, you still went to the beach house,
she
right?
did go to the beach house.
Like I said, it was a trap.
But she did go.
I got that already, so... Can you give us the
details about that trap? Did you just see? Did you see Ibuki? She was like in the weird like mouth spit pose for no reason.
I would like to know too. It might lead to some kind of clue.
It might.
Fine. You want me to talk,
huh? Clues.
Earlier this morning, Mahiru was the one who came up to me. She asked if we could meet up later.
Huh? But didn't you say earlier?
Oh, what a lie.
Mm-hmm.
She probably would have, probably said that so people wouldn't suspect her.
So that was a
lie?
Because I thought it'd be doubted if I admitted it. I figured it was better not to say anything.
Yeah, girl B is the one who didn't want anything to do with the murder.
Yep.
So, what was your answer to Mahiru's invitation?
I told her it was fine. I mean, I didn't have a reason to say no. Unlike everyone else here, Mahiru was someone I wasn't embarrassed to be seen with.
Sick burn.
You always have to say something snide.
At the time, we were supposed to meet around 2 p.m., but around noon, there was a letter inside my mailbox.
Oh.
Yeah, this one.
To frame her so somebody, she would go to the beach house?
No, somebody wrote the other one, too. Somebody wrote two with the same handwriting.
I was going to tell you in person, but I couldn't find you, so I put it in
the It's the same letter
box.
That was on Mahiru, but with Hyoko's name signed.
Right.
So somebody tried to get them both there for some reason.
Right.
Wow.
But one of them says 2 p.m. and the other one says 2:30, right?
Oh, yeah. But it's the same letter.
Yeah.
ladder and went to the beach house at that time.
Okay, let's see. It contradicts a letter on Mahiru?
I think so.
Yeah, 230.
230, yeah.
I can prove it with this. This letter, doesn't it look like its contents are different from the letter Mahiru had?
Beach. On the second
island,
2:30, yeah. Somebody wanted to take out both of them.
Whoa! The meeting times are off!
It's also strange that both letters wanted to change their meeting spot to the beach house. It would be plausible if one of them said it, but for both letters to say the same thing?
Yoko! Since you wrote it, what do you think?
She didn't write it.
Like I said, I never wrote the letter. How many times do I have to tell you?
Which letter did the killer forge?
Oh.
I don't know. Which one do you think?
She would have to have forged the second one, right?
The one to come in later?
Yeah.
The one on Mahiru?
Right? Or...
That makes sense. Yeah. I think the one that Mahiru had makes sense.
Because they wanted...
We've only got a minute.
Okay.
Yeah. What do you think?
Well, let's just go for it. No.
Damn it!
Oh.
Okay.
Okay, I think both.
Okay.
I see.
Yeah.
Well, I thought it was both, but then they made me think that it was just one of them.
By saying just which one did they forge, and it's like, I think both.
The killer forged them so they could manipulate their actions. Yeah, that's how we should think about it.
That seems very likely. In fact, if you compare both letters...
They have, like, identical handwriting.
Yes. Confirmed! Just as I assumed.
Detective Nekomaru is on the case. Oh man, I would play a game where you just play as Nekomaru.
Like this part. I was going to tell you in person, but I couldn't find you, so I put this in your mailbox. This part. It seems that on this part, let's keep it a secret.
Okay, we get it. It's the same.
Yeah.
The killer forged both of those letters.
In doing so, they were able to control Hiyoko and Mahiru to do their bidding.
You know, like a netherworld puppeteer. Like a netherworld puppeteer.
Yeah, so like there is
and are and everywhere.
Mahiru's killer.
Turn around. There's a puppeteer.
How mean! Give me back Mahiru!
Aww.
Really? This is really terrible. I've offered to help so many times. But the killer this time didn't discuss their plan with me at all.
I just want to help kill
guys,
someone.
I just want to be part of it.
Unreliable.
Here we go again. Once we let our guard down, this happens. We can just lightly punch him to death later.
Just lightly.
So based on what the letter said, you went to the beach house at 2 p.m., right, Hiyoko?
What's most important is what happened afterward. What on earth happened there?
I fell asleep.
What?
Why'd you fall asleep? It's not like I wanted to. I think I was forced to get a whiff of some kind of medicine or something.
Medicine?
Medicine? That medicine. Could it be?
Oh, maybe. There is that drugstore on the second island that we saw.
Hmm.
I thought that place seemed unsafe. They even have prescription medicines laying out in the open.
If you were aware of that from the start, you should have done something about it.
What?
I'm sorry. When I woke up,
that
I
was the weakest I'm sorry read.
And when I rushed out,
inside the closet,
which is why she was crying.
Oh man, she was trying to like frame them, saying like, "Oh, she must have like been." I don't know.
That's why you ran out of the beach house in such a panic.
I was scared. I was really, really scared. Really scared that I couldn't help, but. The killer probably planned to friend Hyoko from the start.
Mm-hmm.
And for that reason, they summoned Hyoko before Mahiru, put her to sleep, and shoved her inside the closet.
So their reason for blocking the door with Mahiru's body was to make Hyoko leave her footprints as evidence.
Everything was done to frame Hyoko as the killer.
That's horrible! I didn't do anything wrong, and I was framed by Mahiru's killer!
That's sad.
And it's a bummer. Framed for killing your best friend?
Yeah.
Hyoko, please do not cry. We believe you.
Is it really okay to believe her?
Yes,
so
dude,
easily?
Every single bit of her, like, framing has been.
This will never end if you keep being so suspicious.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Isn't that what a class trial is all about?
The yeah, well, you didn't help collect the evidence.
Suspicious. This is where we go to thoroughly doubt each other. So if you believe in each other so easily, then there's definitely something wrong with you.
You're wrong, Fuyuhiko. We aren't supposed to doubt each other here. We're supposed to work together. The class trial is where we cooperate with each other, work hard, and aim for victory.
Mm-hmm. Together, friendship, and murder.
Two hopes attempting to grasp the one true hope.
Two hopes grasping one hope? I don't understand.
Yeah. I accidentally said. I was trying to say hopes and grasping, and I got two gropes.
Alright.
Not intentionally. Just what happened.
I'm on the side of the absolute hope that can overcome any despair. And I believe that absolute hope exists at the point where two hopes clash.
Your stance is neither white nor black, but gray. And you do not yearn for your life, or even for victory.
Jeez, I wish he'd just side with the enemy already so I can believe what he said.
Let's stop.
It'd be easier, yeah.
Nagito says is a waste of time.
Yep.
Nagito
is a waste of time.
Throwing it down.
We need to figure out who Mahiru's killer is.
Yes.
There should be a new clue contained in what Hyoko has told us. So, let us believe Hyoko's words and discuss it once again with everyone.
Yep, yep. The debate proceeds when you assume you can believe each other.
Yeah.
Good job. That's the right way.
That's the splendid power of teamwork.
Hey, what do you think of that, Monica? I'm not gonna let you have the outcome you want.
Well, I mean, he gets the outcome he wants either way.
Yeah, he gets whatever outcome he wants.
Whoa, he's sleeping.
Dumbasses. You bastards don't know anything. If you're stupid enough to trust
each
other,
Fuyuhiko.
The only thing waiting for you is the bitter truth.
That's what we're looking for.
Yeah.
Is a cruel ending. Oh no. Are we gonna get the bad end?
I think we're doing well. What is happening now?
Oh, we're halfway through.
Okay. And we've got a halfway through Monokuma Theater where he makes us think that our game is gonna melt.
Yeah. Reached his climax. Oh no, he's just gonna give us the answer this time.
Oh, okay.
That's nice. That's really helpful, Monokuma, because, oh boy, I think it's Pekko?
I think it's Pekko too.
We would be shocked. Oh. innovative is a strong word. Club President and I are powerless against innovation.
Club President?
The club president. What? Yeah, what? Who's the... Oh, okay, maybe club president is the one controlling him? What club? That's what I want to know. Okay, you close your eyes and cover your ears, I'll see it.
I don't think he's actually going to do
it.
No,
I don't think he is either.
Okay.
I was just playing along.
Oh, okay, I'll play along.
I was doing a little funny bit for everyone at home.
Okay, I'm closing my eyes.
Okay.
Correct. You say Nanu in German when you're surprised.
What? It does feel wrong. Okay, that was it.
Well, okay.
That did nothing. Just said Nanu.
Yes, please.
All right, well, and that'll do it for this episode.
All right, see you in the next one where we discover the truth.
Discover the truth about the killer and hopefully don't get caught up on the most confusing clue combo of all time.
Well, after that we did pretty good. So
no, we did good right after. It was that one was just nonsense banana talk.
Yep, nonsense banana talk.
All right, we'll see you next time.
Bye.
Bye.
Next time.
On Panic Heart Plays.
It was just a fridge.
Yeah, but they had all different kinds of sodas.
I bet they hid in the refrigerator is what I'm claiming right now.
Okay, well now I'm out of ideas.
I used to think I was such a good detective.